Hi there, this is Josh at TechPodge. Thanks for joining my channel. So today I'm going to cover Adobe Illustrator artboards. So if you're new to Illustrator or you simply want a quick review of artboards, how they work, how to adjust them, how to export them, and so on, then this is going to be a great video for you. So let's get started. So an artboard is what you put your art on in Illustrator. And you need to choose from any number of presets in here, which are going to give you the exact size of the product you want to create, whether that's an A4, a postcard, or a common web page. You can also click on more presets, and you'll find presets across all these categories: mobile, web, print, film and video, art and illustration, and so on. You can also find some free templates here too. So if I go back to mobile, I'll start with this example here, iPhone X. You can see here it's populated all the details here: the width, the height, the pixels as a unit of measurement. It's giving me a vertical orientation, and I can also create as many artboards as I like over here too. I can stick with one as the default, or I can increase it to say two. So I'm going to click create, and now I've got two iPhone X size artboards. So these are my two artboards in the size of an iPhone X, and you can see I can begin putting stuff on here right away. I'll just give you a couple of quick examples. So I've created a cyan rectangle there. I'll create a green one over here, and you can see now I've got some artwork here. Now, if I want to adjust these artboard sizes, all I need to do is go over here to the artboard tool and click on that. And as soon as I click on that, it's going to open up this artboard and identify it as the selected artboard. So this is the active artboard. This one is not, this one is. And now I can go over here and I can change the size of this artboard. I can change it in three different ways, actually. I can change it over here in the right-hand panel. As you can see here the dimensions here, or up top here under this control menu. And by the way, if you don't see this bar here, simply click on window and then click on control, and then it will show. And the last way that I can actually adjust this artboard is simply by double clicking on it. And now here you go, here's my third option. So basically Adobe gives you three different places to change it. You can double click on it, you can change it on the control bar or over here in the properties panel. So if I want to rename this artboard, I can simply rename it ABC. Now it's named ABC. I can change the preset size, right? I can change from any of these presets. I can do the same over here or over here. And I can also change orientation. So vertical or horizontal. And by the way, I can also override these. So I can simply type it in manually if I choose to. And I can also add a center mark. So if I want a tool to help me see how to align things better, I can actually add a center mark and crosshairs. Click OK, and now you can see I've got the crosshairs and the center mark. You can't see it very well, so let me drag it over here. Let me use the selection tool to move this rectangle out of the way, and there you go, there it is. So when I put it here, you can see it's going to show me exactly when it lines up, and now it's just telling me right now it's at the center. So there you go. Very easy to use. If I double-click on that, to go back to the artboard tool, double-click on that. Once again, you can see here, I can take these off, and now I can also change the region outside to a light gray if I prefer that. I click there, you can see it's now light gray, but I'm going to keep that dark gray because I find that much easier to read. I prefer that default. And you can see here, it's also telling you you've got two artboards here. So in this document, which is entitled 80, it's showing me that I've got two artboards within it. I'm also going to show you how to use this tool as well to duplicate an artboard. And all you do is click on the Alt and drag your cursor to duplicate it. So let's do that now. Cancel on that. I'm going to zoom out a little bit, control minus, and now I'm going to click on Alt and click and drag, and now I've duplicated the artboard. So it's that easy. You simply click on it and drag, holding down the Alt board the whole time. So now you've got a duplicate artboard. So if you want to export any of these, it's very simple. All you do is simply go up to File and now click onto the Export, and now click Export As. And now you're going to see that you have to actually select the artboard that you want to actually export. So I'm going to call this example, and I'm going to go down here. I want it to be a PNG, but you could change it to any document, actually. You could do JPEG, PNG, etc. Keep it as a PNG. Now I'm going to select Use Artboard, and now I need to make sure that I actually select the right artboard. Okay, I've got four in the list here, so if I select, for example, the fourth one, now I can click Export. Now it's going to take me to this page, and it's going to show me that this is the artboard, which is this one right here, the last one that I created. Okay, so if I click on OK, it's now going to let me export that, and it's going to find that. I'm going to be able to find it on my desktop. So I hope you found this video helpful and instructive. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing. I'm going to produce many short videos just like this one basically around 5 minutes on just about all the Adobe products and many other creative products that digital artists and digital creatives use. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.